Hello everyone, I'm Sharmila, the architect of Space Kidz India.
Hello everyone, I'm Kowshika, research scholar at Space Kidz India. So when I was young, people used to come and ask me, what are you going to do in life? Honestly, at that time, I didn't have any reply to them because I myself didn't know what am I going to do in my life. I was just a funny girl, playful girl. And one day when I was 10 years old, my father came up to me. He asked me, can you write a poem? I said, okay, Dad, poem. I'll try my best. That night, I sat and I wrote a poem. Next morning, I showed it to everyone. Everyone was shocked, surprised. They were like, you wrote it in the same way of new generation way of writing. It has a pinch of classical Tamil. What a talent. Nothing went into my mind. They just asked me to write a poem. I wrote it. That's all. So my family forced me to study literature. So because my grandfather was a national level Tamil writer. So after him, in the second generation, everyone were mostly writers and speakers. So they want someone to take this art to the next generation to spread ideas and thoughts. That's why they forced me to study literature. But the reason behind me to study literature at a very young age was, after I win each and every competition, my dad used to take me to a movie. Still, I remember watching many movies in school uniforms. So just to go sit, watch a movie the previous night, I would be preparing very hard for the competitions. So gradually, I developed love for literature because literature taught me one thing in life. Whatever you see is science. Everything around you is science. My eyes were attracted towards Vayu Sastras and Pushpaka Vimanas. And that sowed the seed for love and passion towards space science in me. And every night I could sleep, I wish if I were at Mars at this moment, how will I be? Or can I just go visit Moon when I have time or during my vacations? Because I love traveling. Traveling makes me more and more happier. I just want to go, explore things, solve mysteries. That triggered me. Why just exploring to nearby places? Why can't I explore to the whole world, universe, galaxies, planets, and play games with the mystery of space science? My home is just near to airport. I can see the whole airport. It's just half a kilometer. So when I was young, I used to sleep in the terrace with my parents. That time I used to see the takeoff and landing of flights. I used to say to my dad, Dad, one day you please take me. I want to travel in flight. And when I see stars, no, I'll be joining all the stars, calling my mom and saying that, Mom, this is of cat shape. This is of dog shape. Then in future, no, I thought, why I'm wishing to fly in a flight? Why can't I make a flight of myself and go out of the space and explore everything? And that point came in my life. Like an election result, everyone were waiting for me. Either aerospace over literature or literature over aerospace. I said, both. Aerospace at Hindustan, literature at my home. I'm currently pursuing my second year B.Tech Aerospace Engineering degree at Hindustan Institute of Technology and Science.
My childhood is actually very weird. I changed my school like six times, yes, six. The first two times, I literally begged my mom to put me back in the old school because I missed my friends. And she always said I would find better friends in the new school. But I ended up finding different friends, not better friends. The third time I changed my school, I became an extrovert. I became a pro at it. I never cried. I was brought up in the great kingdom of Saudi Arabia. I met people from different states, different countries, different culture, different lifestyle, and that was the start of it. Being in such a country means I was just locked up in the room. You're not supposed to go out alone. And that's why I wanted to choose a time pass. I wanted entertainment when I came back from school. And that's when my kindergarten doodling took a huge leap. I started sketching whatever I saw around me. I was interested in drawing, sketching, and I never limited my categories to a specific limit. I did portraits, landscapes, sceneries, and that gave a kickstart to miniature model making, sculpture making, craft works, etc. I was just mad in love with designing. What do the girls carry in their bags usually? Eyeliners, lipsticks, but I was a female who always carried sketchbooks and pencils. If design was a man with blood or flesh, I would have just married him. That's how mad I was in love with design. And then came the worst part of any student's life, the most terrific part. Son, doctor, engineer. There are few who are forced to choose their profession by their parents, and there are few others like me who fight for their passion, who fight for what they love, and then they choose their profession.
Hey, wait. Even I fought in my home. I literally didn't eat for 1 week till my parents agreed to take this course.
Okay, so she comes under my category. I had three options in my mind. The first one was design. The second one was design. The third one was again design. I was just lunatically in love with design. And then I came across architecture, a course which is not just about designing buildings, a course which you can design anything and everything around you. That's what all architects say, but we eventually end up designing only buildings. And right now I'm doing my third year architecture in Miyasi Academy, Chennai, and I'm still surviving.
So when I was at class 6, a poster was put up in our school's notice board. So stating that students interested to visit NASA can come forward. From nowhere, it created a lot of excitement in me. The facts that I read in the book is going to be witnessed by me in real. And how cool is that? Yes, I just wanted to go. And that's how I met our mentor, our mother, CEO of Space Kidz India, Dr. Srimadhi Kesan. So from that time, I started sharing all my ideas to her, even though they were lame and funny, capturing a comet, building houses and moons, and everything. Gradually, I developed my skill. I started presenting papers on life on different planets, moons, because I just wanted to leave my hometown, explore everything. So that triggered me to do all these things. Our team was the first team to launch the balloon satellite in India, NSLV. And our team was the first team to invent the lightest satellite, which weighs only 64 grams, and it is of a size of 3.8 centimeter cube. And I got the prestigious opportunity to represent our Kalamsat team in an international medium in a competition called Junior Edison 5, organized by China. I think that step in my life was like suddenly I jumped out of the sky. Everyone started identifying me. Before all these things, no, everyone knows me just as a tiny girl who always stands front row in the school assembly. No other go I should stand in the front row. Even if I sit in the second row or if I stand in the second row, I can't see anything. Everyone used to call me with a nickname because of my size, how tiny I look. I don't want all those identity. I should create my identity of myself. If a teacher wants to call me also, she'll be like, hey, call the tiny girl. I don't want this identity in my life. I just wanted to erase all those things and create something new. And that's where my journey started. And Sharmila, you are an architect. How did you come into space field?
Okay, so there was this post in Facebook about the planets around us. And I ended up commenting in a funny way, how about building something on Saturn? And the lead scientist of Space Kidz, Rifat Shahrukh, came across that comment. And the conversation just started. We were discussing about our passion, our goals and aims and etc. And he asked me if I can design a moon rover for them. Wait, a moon, which is something in the space. I had no clue. I was someone who just designed buildings. And he's talking something which is in the space, on the moon, a moon rover. And I explored the space. I started learning about it. And I came up with the world's lightest moon rover design, which is going to be launched in the year 2019. And that was the moment when I was unoblivious. Till then, I was one among the crowd who designed only buildings, a crowd among all the architecture students. And when I thought something out of the box, out of all the buildings, something beyond the Earth's atmosphere to the space, that's when people started recognizing me. That's when I shifted from an architect, from an ordinary architect, to a space architect. And eventually, I got another opportunity by our mentor, Srimati Kesan, to design a spaceport in Rajasthan, and I didn't stop there. Simultaneously, I wanted to share my knowledge of design and technology to the upcoming generation, and right now I'm working on a one-year crash course for architecture and interior designing for school students. This is just for school students. See, I always believe in law of attraction and law of destiny. Law of attraction is nothing but whatever you love for wholeheartedly, it always finds its way back to you. And law of destiny, whatever is meant for you, even if you don't like it, even if you have no clue about it, even if you haven't done about it, I mean, even if you haven't done that before, like how me designing a moon rover from buildings, it will always find its way back to you. And okay, let's keep the space, the moon rover, aerospace, literature, everything aside, we are doing something right now totally out of the box. Kowshika?
So, as an engineer, we wanted to do something to the society. And for me, I have two things. As an engineer and also as a speaker, I wanted to do something to the society. My thoughts, I don't want it to be constrained only for that 5-minute speech. And I want to put my knowledge of chemistry in this field also. So I wanted to link all these three things. So that's where we stopped at this project, something to the society. So why not in the field of agriculture? So soon we will be coming up with a project where we can cultivate crops only in salt water. So this is not to make any hybrid crops. We are just working on the totipotency level of the crops to accept salt water. And this project is not only for Earth and also for space. Yes, we are working on space farming also. So we thought something else also for the society. So what we can do? So we are currently working under many medicines for different diseases which have been termed by doctors as not curable. We are also working under the treatment of cancer. So apart from this, the major thing is relating ancient theoretical science with modern practical science. To be clear, I learned black hole theories not from science fiction movies, from Ramanujan. I learned the theory of evolution not through Charles Darwin, but through Kambaramayanam. And instead of learning flight dynamics, aerodynamics, propulsion, everything from my engineering books, I learned it from Vayu Sastra. Can you all guess who may be the scientist who inspired me a lot, fascinated me about the science, who inspired me? Any guesses, random guesses, who may be the scientist? Any one or two guesses?
No one?
Actually, this scientist lived 10,000 years ago. She's a woman scientist. Her name is Andal. Yes, she's a goddess for everyone, right? We all keep her inside temple as an idol. But I see her as a scientist because my teacher taught me what is condensation process only in the standard of 6. But when I was reading her verses in the standard of 2, I learned what is condensation through the poem Aali Malai Kanna Onjini Kai Karavel. So this is what. Literature doesn't constrain itself with similes, metaphors, praising women, praising nature. No. It's everything beyond that. It teaches you what science is. And that's what we are currently working on in making different arrow modeling structures from your ancient science, theoretical science. And I have been criticized everywhere for my appearance. But I have never been worried for it. Because each and every time they criticize, no? Even I laugh with them. But I just wanted to prove this world that appearances are deceptive. As a team, we wanted to change the entire world from the deep soil to the outermost space. And that's what we are working on. Chase your wildest dream. Don't expect for anyone to come sit near you, listen, oh, you love your dream so much. No one cares for you that how much you love your dream or passion. You should know how much you love your dream. Have the fear of failure. Each and every time you win, have the fear of failure. The fear of failure will help you to overcome your overconfidence. And each and every time you fail, don't give up because it's your first attempt in learning. Keep on learning and believe that hard work really pays. Yes, it's really true words that hard work pays. And I thank you all for giving this wonderful opportunity.
Thank you, TEDx family, for giving us this wonderful opportunity to get inspired and inspire you guys. And thank you, lovely audience. Thank you, guys.